Hey everyone, it's Jared here with Heat Press Nation, and I am super excited to be unboxing and installing our brand new Silhouette Curio 2. Now in this video, I'm gonna be unboxing this beast solo, but please feel free to get help. It's definitely a lot easier when you have two people working on this unboxing. So first things first, let me get out my trusty box cutter and we're gonna open this up. There we go. So now, before we tip it back over, we're gonna pop this tab and we are going to open the lid. We're gonna open this other lid. As you can see, we have some diagrams, small diagrams printed on top of each of these flaps. They're gonna indicate to us how to slide this out. One rule of thumb, the front of the box is gonna be the top. So we're gonna tip this over very carefully. Like so, there we go. And we're gonna slide this over. So this is what it's gonna look like for you. So we're gonna grab the machine right here and we're gonna slide it on out. Let's do this. I'm gonna grab my machine right by the base and I'm gonna carefully slide it out. I'm grabbing the top here. You can grab here if you want to, carefully. And we're gonna slide it out. Carefully sliding the box off. And there we go. Man, this thing is a beast. But I absolutely love it. So now we're gonna carefully remove the styrofoam from our machine. Actually, before we do that, right here on top, this is the electrostatic bed and the protective sheet. So I'm gonna carefully just set this to the side. Right here on top, we have part of our power supply. We have the power cable. We have some masking tape. And then we also have our auto blade and blade adjuster. Let's go ahead and set those to the side. And then right here, I almost didn't see it because it's white, it's camouflaged. Here we go. I imagine this is the power supply. Let's see. Yes, this is the rest of our power supply. Let's go ahead and set that to the side. All right, now I'm checking everywhere, making sure I didn't miss anything. Okay, so now we can go ahead and slide this off. Oh, okay, cool. That makes things a lot easier. Be sure you save these styrofoam molds. You don't want to lose them or break them, just in case you ever have any issues with warranty or you need to have this machine serviced when you ship it back. You do have to have it, everything together. So there we go. Carefully lift it up and remove it. And then on this side, we're going to carefully lift it up and remove it. There we go. Oh, this thing is beautiful. I'm already super excited. Let's go ahead and take it out of the bag now. There we go. Oh, this is so exciting. Now, one thing that's very interesting to note is right here. So now these instructions here, they're taped in place so you don't miss them. So this is the warning. Okay, it's written in a few different languages and it's letting you know that there is a bracket attached to this machine to keep the main action, I don't even know what this is called exactly, but the main assembly piece, keeping that intact. So before we do anything, let me go ahead and rotate this and I'm gonna show you what exactly that is. So right here, this bracket is keeping this main piece all together. So I don't know, maybe I could have lifted it up by there, but I don't want to, I don't want to risk it. So before we move forward, let's go ahead and remove this here. Now these are all able to be loosened by hand. So then once that's loosened, this bracket comes out of the way and that's it. Now again, you probably wanna wait at least 30 days before you discard these again, just in case there's something, maybe it was damaged in shipping and you just didn't quite see it. Maybe if there's something that you didn't notice. Or again, if you're still within your return period, you must have everything all together. You need everything if you want to return this machine. So I recommend keeping that for at least 30 days. And now is the fun part. Now we can go ahead and remove all this tape. Okay, now I'm gonna carefully move that out of the way. And that should be the final piece of packaging. Now, we should be able to carefully move this back. And now we're gonna install our electrostatic bed. All right, so this is the electrostatic bed that comes with the machine. So we're gonna go ahead and unpackage this right now. Now there are a few notes that I want to make about this is that it is a little bit delicate, especially the surface. As a result, it's going to come with a protective cover. Now this protective cover is this clear plastic that you see attached to it. So please do not think that this is just protective plastic that can just be discarded. No, no, no. This right here, don't lose that. So these tabs should be in the open position, outside, meaning outside position. But just in case, double check, and then we're gonna go ahead and place our mat at the front, or our bed, I should say. We're just gonna slide that on in. Make sure it's nice and snug, and then we're gonna secure it in place with our tabs. Now, our protective sheet, it's gonna be in this bag right here. We're not gonna apply it right now, but I will show you how to use it in our next video where we cover our very first project. But just so you can see what it looks like, this is it right here. It's a piece of clear, protective, feels almost like vinyl. And it's gonna go like so on your Curio. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We're gonna show you exactly how this is done in our next video where we do our very first project with the Curio 2. Well, let's proceed. First, we're gonna download and install Silhouette Studio. Go to www.silhouetteamerica.com/setup and select your language. We recommend signing into your Silhouette account and registering your new machine. But if you wanna skip that step, go ahead and click on the Silhouette Curio 2. Step one is actually going to cover everything we just showed in the unboxing. So if you've been following along, you can scroll down and click continue to the next step. This is where you're gonna download the Silhouette Studio software. You'll have three different options, which you will select based on your computer's operating system. In this video, we'll be installing the Windows 64-bit version of Silhouette Studio. After the installation file has been downloaded, double-click to run the Silhouette Studio setup wizard. Follow all of the on-screen prompts. When it's done installing, click Finish and open up Silhouette Studio. Let's go to our machine. Hold the power button down for about 2 to 3 seconds or until the machine powers on. You should see the Bluetooth light flashing in blue. This means it's available and ready to connect. If you press the Bluetooth button, it'll turn solid white, meaning that Bluetooth is off. Press it again to go back to available or search mode. Go to the Send panel in Silhouette Studio and select your new Curio 2 from the list of available machines. Click on it to connect. You may need to update the firmware, which can take up to 5 to 10 minutes. If you do, be sure to keep the machine on and Silhouette Studio open the entire time. I would also recommend keeping your Curio 2 as close to your computer as possible for the best connection during this process. Once that's done, Silhouette Studio will show your machine as ready and the Bluetooth light on your Curio 2 will be solid dark blue. This means your Curio 2 has successfully been connected and is ready to go. If you prefer a wired connection, you can use a standard printer-style USB A to B cable. This cable is not included with the Curio 2, but should be available in the electronics section of most big box retailers. You may still need to update the firmware, which should be a little faster on a direct connection. And there you go, we've just unboxed and set up our brand new Silhouette Curio 2. Stay tuned for part two in this series where we perform our very first cut and make our first project. And of course, for more content like this, be sure to subscribe to our channel and hit that notification bell while you're at it. For more Silhouette products and other heat transfer equipment, head on over to heatpressnation.com.